Hey, everybody! It's Harry Carey. for Boston Lock Tech. Here's your host, Gus Greenfield.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know who that guy is. Some homeless guy that I found, he needed a couple bucks. I was like, hey, man, I need an introduction to you. So anyway, hi, everybody. Trying to make these videos quick, but it ain't working out. I'm going to be out here all night long. I want to show you guys some of these cars, and it's like, damn, man. I got 30. I don't even think I've showed you 30 of them yet. It's like, okay, these are sick. So these are still ones from some guy named Don at the local rinky-dink flea market. Shout out to everybody in Rust Belt Racing and 3D Botmaker, that group there, and all the other groups that I'm in. All right, anyway, this is like a, getting back to the cars. Disregard all the junk behind me. That's, never mind that. I'm still saving videotapes and stuff back there from the 80s. All right, this is a Cartoon Friends series, Double Vision, Bullwinkle car. Look at that. Nice. Now see that? See Bullwinkle on there? Nice. And most of the cars that I show on here, if somebody's like really desperate for their collection or whatever, and they want to buy it or whatever, I will sell it. Not all of them, but I'll sell you one or two. If it's not crazy, if you looked up like on Amazon or eBay or whatever, the lowest price and the highest price, I'd probably, if you're a member of my group or whatever, or even if you're not, if you're a nice looking person or something like that, or I'll give it to you for like right in the middle price. You know, if it's like, well, I seen it on there for 10 and I seen it on there for 60, I'll sell it to you for 35 or whatever. Anyway, you pay for shipping though. And they're not 35. I was just using that for a round number.
Am I rambling?
Okay. This is a first edition, I think. No.
No, this is a Hyundai
Spider Concept.
This is like a 2002, I think.
I'm not sure because I can't see. I don't have my bifocals on. But that's a nice looking little car there. I don't think it's a first edition, though.
But like whatever year that is. It, you know, and it's got the coin thing on there with the fire.
It's a good year for them
little cars. And then, let's see.
This one's nice.
Spectra Flame 2, Silhouette 2. Really sharp looking car. Fantasy cars, I'm not into fantasy cars, but for a fantasy car, that's pretty fancy. Pretty fancy. And the card. The card's a little jacked up on top there.
I got this tote down here. I'll have to show you this too. Alright, we're getting down to the bottom here. So like, we got plenty of time in this video yet. This one I thought was pretty cool. But it's just like your basic 50th anniversary Austin Martin 1963 DBS, but you know, for 007 Skyfall, for a basic car, basic. You can't beat that.
You can't beat that. With a wooden stick for a basic. That car is awesome.
You know, because it was James Bond, they should actually put that backwards in the pack like a Matchbox, you know. Everybody would think
they got an error. But no, it's a James Bond car, man. Matchbox, Lindsay. You know, England. James Bond. I like them English dudes. I used to work for the Queen.
Okay, let's see. Here's one. This is an old one. Has a price tag on it from Ollie's. I'm not sure what year this is, but it's a Halloween car. But not this year's Halloween. Tricked out treats will sweeten the spooky season.
This car is nice. I don't know what it is. Zodiac.
Look at that.
Sorry, it's blurry. There you go. And top. Okay, there's the Always. I don't know what year that is. I don't know how old, if that's like 2 years old or a year old or 10 years old. There's a... Okay, there you go. That's kind of cool. Here's another one of them giant ones, which is like not to scale, but new for 1995. This is a Mercedes SL. It's a nice looking car, but it just, I don't know, something don't about it just don't look right. It looks too big. Too big. Too big. But anyway, I bet you it goes down the track pretty good. Plastic on the bottom. Here's one. A Mercedes SLK. I must have hit like a Mercedes pocket or something. Mercedes SLK from 1998. You wish it was 1970. Huh? 1998, first edition. Number 11 of 40 cars. I don't know why I'm slurring. Okay, here you go.
Nice, huh?
Okay. All right, sorry if it's blurry, but you know. How much was that? 82 cents.
Back in 1998. Man, that's amazing that they keep them. That's
steel on steel, too, you know. Like, that's why they got to go plastic now. They still keep them on a buck. That still amazes me. These things should actually be... Well, some of them are $5 now, you know? Cool ones. Ugh. I got a whole bunch of... what do you call them? Johnny Lightnings, too. So, if anybody's into Johnny Lightnings, I have some stuff that you might be kind of excited about. Okay, we got... I try to keep these like about 12 minutes. I usually end up going over about a minute. So that was it for the ones that I got from Don. I think I might cut this one short because that was like the end of those three videos there. I should like number these.
I'm going to do my next video. I'm going to try to fly.
Oh, you know what? Here, I got something for you. Oh, no. Never mind. I can't. That's something for my Rust Belt Racing guys. You can see it on there. I don't know what else to tell you. Anybody got any questions? Anybody? No? No? Okay. Sorry about the mess back here. This is my dump area.
And these videos is like, you know, I actually don't
wear the same clothes every day. I'm actually making these videos all in. Well, you probably figured that out. I'm just cutting them up in like short segments, so, you know.
It's kind of boring
watching an hour's worth of freaking cars, but some of these cars are pretty neat, and some people are into it. You know, they like seeing this stuff. I know I do. I'll lay on a couch and watch somebody like Race Grooves doing box openings and stuff, and all them guys. I like that little guy, Matthew. You ever watch Matthew opening boxes up? He's good, and he's fast. Shout out to him. He's pretty cool. I like that, dude. And, of course, Race Grooves and the other various guys that do them. The guy that does kind of like the, I can't understand the one guy, but he always gets the cases before anybody else.
And can you believe
that we're into the A case date
on the map in 2020 already? So, man, I can't believe it. I
don't have any cars from, I don't think the Q case. I might have some from the P, but I was still like looking for stuff from M&N. And did you guys see that one with that I took with the guy in Walmart cutting open all the boxes, all the cases, and stealing, not stealing, I mean, he's paying for them, but he's taking the treasure hunt, and if there's a super treasure hunt out of there and an ID car out of there, you know, he cuts it, opens up this side, takes it, cuts this side, opens up, takes it, opens up another case. He did 10 cases. I videotaped him a little bit. I couldn't believe it.
If anyone wants to know who he is and where he works and where his house number is and
his phone number and stuff like that, just, nah, I wouldn't do that. But the guy's a dick, you know? I look at it like if I find, if I'm in wherever, like you say Walmart, and, you know, there's a dump bin there, I'll dig through them dump bins, and if I find treasure hunts in there, I'm keeping them. I'm keeping them because I work for that. Or on the pegs, you know? But just... standing there with employees, they're stuck in the shelves and the boxes are sitting there and you're cutting them open, taking the shit out, putting it here, you know, and then you just take all the treasure hunts and then them brand new dump bins, people come in there, they're all excited. Oh man, look, a dump bin. They'll dig through them sons of bitches and you know, they got like three or six of them there. And there won't be one damn treasure hunt in that whole whole freaking thing. I actually called the Walmart or left a message and sent them a, you know, kind of like, hey man, that ain't fair. But, you know, it didn't matter. But anyway, that's just like kind of bullshit. So if you're ever there and you're doing that, and I know a lot of people do that, but just like take a few for yourself. You know, sometimes I'll find, if I find a bunch of them, like I was at a Walgreens and I found a, they must have opened up like three cases. And I found, I didn't find any supers, but I found the three treasure hunts that were there. There must have been a treasure hunt in every, all three cases. And I took them, but I didn't. I took two of them and I left one right on top. But there was like some other stuff there and I kind of like set it up there. So whoever's the guy or the girl is looking through them, they'll be like, man, somebody got the, they were like in a flat bin too, so you could see all the cars. And it was like, they look up like their back's hurting and they look up and boom, that treasure hunt will be right there in their face. So I did that. And then I didn't keep both treasure hunts. I kept one for myself. It was that little yellow truck for 2020, the art truck that looks like hell. And I gave one to a buddy of mine. He had another treasure hunt and we kind of traded, so it was cool. So, you know, that stuff's fair, but I mean, you open up 10 cases and take the treasure hunt out of each one and then walk away and somebody's got to go through that damn dump bin and, you know, I just kind of like frown on that a little bit. But, you know, maybe, I don't know, maybe I'm just jealous because I didn't find it first. I wouldn't have done that. I wouldn't have. I actually, I was at Walgreens today and I bought some 5-packs and a lady couldn't get a price on the one of them. She goes back, gets a price, and I'm walking out and I was like, I was looking at my receipt and was like, you know, I think she just ripped herself off. So I went back in there, and she's like, what's wrong? And I was like, I think you ripped yourself off. For these 5-packs are $5.49. And I was like, see here, I got these 10. You get 10 for 10. And then I had a 2 5-packs. So it was like those were $5.49 each. And then so that was like another $10, $11. And I was like, there was no other third 5-pack on there. So she didn't, you know, she was really appreciative. She goes, you know what she said, though? She said, you know, most men wouldn't do that. And I'm like, well, what the heck, man? You don't like men or what? But anyway, I said, I'm like the, I'm a one percenter, so. I don't know if you people know what that is, but I'm a good person now. I used to be, you know, 1%. It's like 99% of the people obey the law, and then you got the 1%. Yeah, I guess I'm still a 1%er, but I'm an honest 1%er. Good guy. Yeah, I'm one of the good guys now. Actually, I bought a collection of cars off of a guy today. He's a bounty hunter, and he's getting older and stuff like that. I sent him a after he gave me a really, really good deal on a collection, which I'll be showing you on one of these videos. But I told him, I said, man, you need any help catching bad guys, man, because he's getting older and stuff. He's like, oh yeah, I'll be all into that. Anyway, all right, back when I was little, I used to repossess cars in Tampa, Florida. But that was fun. Okay. Hey, this is already overrunning, and I didn't get it to show you enough cars, so I'm going to stop this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If this is on YouTube, please like and subscribe, but I probably don't even care about that, so this will just be on Facebook, and just enjoy it, and hopefully you guys like the cars. And I'm Gus Greenfield. And for Harry Carey and G. William Bell, Little Debbie, and all the other people at Busted Luck Tech, have a good weekend. We're out of here.